This is Dave Mosher, Products Editor for Popular Science. We're here at Temple University, where a team of 5 engineering students are building a scale model of a Wright flyer. They're going to run it off a 30-foot cliff for Red Bull Flugtag. Let's check it out.
So, what's Red Bull Flugtag? It's a competition in which teams from around the world build homemade, human-powered flying machines. The goal? Push them off a 30-foot-tall pier over a body of water and try to get them to fly, or just look really hilarious. This year, the Temple Aeronautics Design Team is competing in the Washington, D.C. event.
Who are you guys, and what are you trying to do here?
I'm Omar Mulka.
I'm Greg Oakley.
Kyle Eldridge.
And we're at Temple Aeronautics Design, and we are trying to beat the standing flugtag world record.
Why the heck would you want to build something like this?
I guess we needed something that had some good engineering principle to it, because we're doing it partially for school, and just because we wanted to build something that we knew would fly.
As opposed to other flugtag devices, which are, you know, chickens or hamburgers or lobsters, you're actually trying to build a real flying machine. Why did you choose to do that instead of doing something really silly?
Well, doing something really silly doesn't really take too much effort. It's more of just designing the thing for looks and cosmetics, but we're going for something that's mechanically sound and will actually pick up wind. And that's even more exciting, trying to beat a world record than getting to push something off.
Made of paper mache.
Right.
Speaking of engineering, this looks an awful lot like a Wright Brothers contraption. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
When we decided to do the project, we went to our advisor and said that we were thinking about entering Flugtag and maybe we could redesign the Wright Brothers 1902 glider, and he happened to have plans for it already. That kind of spiraled from there. We took it down by 5/8 scale ratio.
We're looking at roughly the same amount of lift and drag to, you know, get the thing flying.
Yeah. Do you guys think your pilot can do it? Do you think he's going to crash and burn, or do you think he can actually pull it off, you know, get out of that?
I think he has the nerves.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you know, he's got to hold this elevator in front. He's got to hold it down. The dive bomb is going to go down probably 20 feet before he starts to try to level off.
Right. He needs to somehow keep his composure and, like, stay centered, which we're not really allowed a seatbelt, which I think is, like, not fair at all, because the guy that has the world record still had one. So we might have to strap him in illegally or something. I don't know.
But have something for him to hold on to, yeah.
Right, yeah.
What was the hardest part of this aircraft to you, right?
Well, the fabric for us, but then the bending was
these bend
for
pieces.
It, which Tommy did. There was like 43 of them on the actual glider. He had to soak them in water for a little under a week. Basically make forms
form.
With
yeah.
Nails and just leave them there until they were totally dry.
What's the best case scenario and the worst case scenario?
In best case, you know, we're definitely aiming for that record. And hopefully maybe 250, 300 feet. Worst case, our canard doesn't work and we kind of just dive bomb right into the water.
So, we'll see this Saturday if this thing actually flies. For Popular Science, this is Dave Mosher.
See you in D.C.